Right now, the United States is going through a lot of transformation, particularly in the political area. We see more and more extreme positions being taken, even some extreme actions being taken. Can you see a world in which we start to erode away that advantage of being born in the United States in this particular time?
I don't think so. I've seen, going back to the late 60s, early 70s, I mean, we were torn apart over Vietnam, and we had a president resign. I mean, we go through all kinds of things. I mean, we went through a Great Depression. We went through a great panic that almost turned into another Great Recession not that long ago. But this country moves forward. It'll keep moving forward. The luckiest person in the history of civilization is the baby being born in the United States today.
But how much does it depend on where they're born and to whom they're born and what circumstances? The difference between the top quintile and the bottom quintile is growing apart. It's not growing together.
We have the problem of a family that's getting richer and richer and richer. And the market system, which works wonderfully in terms of delivering output, now gives more and more to the people at the top. And if you go back 200 years in the agrarian society, 80% of the people on the farm, if you were the best farmer in the world or best farm hand and I was the worst, there was some differential in our ability, but it wasn't 1,000 for 1 or 100 for 1. And as society gets more specialized, more and more rewards from the market system will flow to the people at the top unless we do something about it.
We're coming up with the 10th anniversary of the great financial crisis. And most people agree that, in fact, as the financial markets are safer because we've taken more reserves out of the banks.
Well, we've added to the reserves that the banks need to hold. And we've curbed their activities to some extent. The banking system is way better shape now than it was in 2008.
So we're talking about the financial system. They're just rejoining us now. Coming up with the financial system and the extent to which we took more reserves from the banks.
Well, we made them put up more capital relative to deposits, and we've done other things too. Our banking system isn't great yet, but we'll have panics in the future.
The banking system's a great system, but in part it's pulled back some, and other asset managers have stepped in. We have now BlackRock with $6 trillion, for example. For that matter, Berkshire Hathaway. We've shifted it from bankers to investors. So said, does that make the system safer?
The system will always have a panic from time to time. It won't come from exactly the same cause. Dodd-Frank did one thing, and it's 2,000 pages, so it did a lot of things, but it did one thing actually probably would make it a little more difficult to deal with a certain kind of panic, because it is the power of the Fed to act in a panic, sort of unilateral, and say, that this will end now, has been diminished. And I think that was a mistake.
Do we need federal regulation of the non-bank banks?
Well, we need some kind of regulation. If people are in massive lending activities, that we need, whatever their names, we need some kind of regulation. There's no question about that. The market system is wonderful, but animal spirits can go too far.
Finally, as you say, Warren, it's your 88th birthday, which is terrific. Look back. On a 38-year-old, Warren Buffett, instead of an 88-year-old, if you were starting out today, would the principles that got you to where you've gotten still apply? In a world of so much technology, in a world of globalization, a lot of things have changed. Have they changed the fundamentals of investing?
Well, the principles, no, they haven't changed at all. I mean, you try to evaluate where a business is going to be in 5 or 10 or 20 years, and you try to buy it at the right price relative to that valuation, and you leave alone the ones you don't understand, and you do not try to guess the market. It's exactly what Ben Graham wrote in 1949, and no, the principles don't change at all.
So Ben Graham still applies.
Absolutely.